One, how are you all? Are you helping your mama? Yes, how? Okay, tell me what all things you can do. Can you brush your teeth? Can you wash your hands? Can you take bath? Can you lay the dining table? Can you make your bed? Can you keep your room clean? Can you keep your toys back in the proper places? Can you dance? Can you sing? And can you write neatly? If not, then please start doing all this. And if yes, then it's very good because you all have the ability to do that. And why ma'am is asking you all these questions? And you noticed one thing, that all these questions are beginning with can, because it is today's topic. We are going to learn a few more helping words. And what are they? They are can, could, may, and might. So, as ma'am told you, today's topic is can, could, may, and might. And you know, they are also the helping verbs. We know about the verbs and few of the helping verbs. What are verbs? Verbs are the action words. And what are the helping verbs? They are the words used to support the verbs. Today, we will learn a few more helping verbs. Why are we learning all this? We are learning all this so that we can form correct sentences and can write and speak English correctly. Because if you are learning a new language, you might be confused with some or the other things. So, if we are going to do step by step, then it will be clear and we will not make any mistake. So, let's begin with can. The spelling of can is C-A-N, can. Can tells us about the ability, means that what all things you can do. Like ma'am just asked you that, can you brush your teeth? If yes, then you have that ability. Can you write neatly? If yes, then it means that you have that ability. Then it tells us about the capacity and power. Capacity can be in two senses. First, like if you say that your water bottle contains 1 liter of water. So that is the capacity. It can contain this many liters of water. And if I say that it is her capacity to do something, means she has again the ability to do something. Then power. If I say that I can lift lift a weight of 2 kg, so I am that much powerful that I can lift it. Then possibility, that it can happen, something can happen. Then can is used for permission also. If I want to ask permission from someone, that is, can I go, can I take your pen, then also I can use can. And if I want to offer something to someone, like can I help you, then also I can use can. Now let us see some examples. I can dance. So this is my ability, that I can dance. I can sing. She can swim. So, it is her ability. Everybody cannot swim, but it is her ability that she can swim. He can play guitar. You all like listening to the music? And here what the sentence says, that he can, he has the ability, he has the art of playing guitar. She can solve this problem. So, this means that she is so intelligent that she can solve this problem. I can read. Can you read? If not, then start doing so. I can count. You can count numbers. You can count things. So you have the ability of counting. So you can say this, that I can count. I can draw and color. And I know that all of you are very good artists and everyone can draw and color, isn't it? Now, coming to the another this thing, capacity. This tank can contain 100 liters of water. Means this tank is so big That in it, how many liters of water we can put? 100 liters. This bottle can contain 1 liter of water, like your water bottle or any bottle which you use in daily use, then it can contain 1 liter of water. Then I can lift this box. So it is a heavy box and this is my power that I can lift it. Okay. Now coming to possibilities. Accidents can happen to anyone. So here it is saying that it is not always possible. There are chances that if you are careless, then accidents can happen. Suppose if you are crossing the road. So how you cross? You look towards your right, then to the left, and then again to the right, and then cross. But sometimes if you are in a hurry and you don't do so, so you can get hurt. It is not necessary that you will get hurt, but you can. And if you are playing at home with a matchbox, then what mama says? That you can get hurt, okay? You can catch a cold if you go outside in the rain. So if you go to play in the rain, so there is a possibility that you can catch a cold. My friend can visit me this week. So I'm not sure, but there is a possibility that my friend can visit me this week. Now another use of can is for taking permission. Can I come in? But here the permission, if you want to take the permission using can, you will take the permission from only those who are younger to you, or if you want to take permission from your friend, you want anything from your friend, then you will use can, can. You will not use can when you are talking to an elderly person or to a very respectful person. Okay, then you will use another word. Here, can I come in? You are asking your friend or someone of your age or younger to you that can I come in? Can I say something? So if two people are talking and you want to interrupt, so if you, in that way you can ask, like two of your friends are talking, so what will you say? Can I say something? Can I use your pen? You are asking your friend that can I use my pen? Can I get you something to drink? Now you are asking somebody, you are offering him or her that can I get you something to drink? Can I help you with that work? Now, our next helping verb is could. And could is the past tense. It can be used as a past tense of can. And there are many other uses of could also. So, let's see. Could is used as the past form of can. For example, we'll take a sentence with can. Can I come in? And it changes to could I come in? I can lift this box. I could lift this box that day. Now in the past tense, so we are using could. I could swim when I was young. So I was young in the past tense. That's why we are using could. When I was young, I could dance very well. When I was a kid, means I was a small child like you all, I could climb any tree. So it was very easy for me to climb the tree. I did all that I could. And you already know that did is used in the past tense. So with did, we will use could because it's the past tense of can. Could is also used for asking permission or to make a request more politely. So when we want to say something very politely, then we will use could. We will not use can in that place. For example, could you give me your bike for an hour? So you are asking someone to give his bike. So you should be polite. So which helping verb you will use? Could. Could you help me? So if you are asking for help, you should be polite. So you will use could. Could I have a talk with you? Could you bring me a glass of water? So you are asking that give me a glass of water. So you have to say it politely. Could I borrow your pen, please? Could I get you something to drink, sir? Now here, sir can be a boss or can be any elderly person. So with them, we also always have to be polite. So we are using could. Could you pass me the salt, please? Again, we are requesting. We could try that new Italian restaurant tonight. You could ask your sister to lend you some money. So in the above two sentences, these two code is used for making suggestions. Now coming to our next helping verb, and that is may, M-A-Y, may. So by listening to this word, what comes to your mind? The month of May, isn't it? But this is not that May. It is something different. It is not the month. It is a helping verb. But the difference is just that they both share the same spelling and the same pronunciation. So let us see what it is. May tells us about the possibility, permission, request, blessings, etc. So as we see that can also told us all these things. So what is the difference? Now can, when it tells us about something, about a possibility, it was only 50% chances. But here with may, there are more chances. May is used when there is a lot of chance for the thing to happen. When can, only 50% chances were there. But with may, a lot of chance, around 80 to 90% chances are there. For example, she may agree with your plan. It means that your plan is so good that there are there's a lot of chance that she will agree to it. It may rain this evening. So how are you sure? You must have seen the forecast, the weather forecast. So you are sure and you're saying that it may rain this evening. They may be late because their car crashed down. So you know that their car is not working properly. So that's why you are 80 to 90% sure that they may be late. May is used when we want to take permission about something from an elderly person or from someone whom you respect a lot. In the case of can, it was different. So we used can to take permission from a friend or from someone who is younger to you. But here may is used to ask permission from someone who is elder, someone whom you respect a lot. For example, suppose you want to take permission from your teacher. So what will you say? Ma'am, may I come in? You use this word, right? May I ask a question? So when we have to take permission from an elderly person, from your mama, from your papa, from your grandma, grandpa. So always you are going to use M-A-Y, may. And this is not that may. It is a helping verb. Then you can also use may while talking to your friend also. If you want to ask him, if you have to want to request him for something. Like, may I play with you? So here you are using may, but with friend you have to use can. But here you are using may because you are requesting your friend to do so. That you are requesting that please may I play with you. So you will use may if you are requesting from your doing making a request from your friend. Now may is also used to express your feelings or to tell a wish, a blessing or a desire. For example, may God bless you. So when you touch somebody's feet, what they say? May God bless you. May you live long. May God help you. So in all these, we are expressing our feelings, the feeling of love, the feeling of blessing. May you have a long, happy life. May God make all your dreams come true. Now our next helping verb is might. Might, it can be used as a past form of may as a possibility and for permission. So, for example, I might not be able to come this time. So, if we are using it as a possibility, then in case of may, it was 80 to 90% chances that the thing will happen or it may happen. But if we are using might, then it means that it is very less chance that the thing might happen. It is very less, only 10% or 12, 15%. I might not be able to finish my homework. I might go to the doctor. Very less chances that I will go to the doctor. You might have lost the keys. The shop might be closed today. If you hurry, you might get there on time. I might lift this box. So it is very little possibility because the box is looking very heavy. So I'm saying I might lift it. Very little possibility. Might I use your pen? So here also, if you're taking permission, you are very scared of the person or you're not familiar with that person. So you're using might because you think that your permission will not be granted. This permission will not be granted. Very less chances that it will be granted. So then we will use might. Might I use your pen? Suppose you are in a bank or somewhere such a place where you don't know anyone. So you can ask like this only because it is the person's wish whether he will give you the pen or not. Might I borrow your car? So car is a very big thing. And to ask to borrow that is also something that it is very less chances that it can happen. So there we will use might. So here in the last two sentences, might is used to take permission or say to request someone. Now we are going to practice a few exercises. Exercise 1, fill in the blanks with can or could. So number 1, I-read. So what will come? I can read because it is my ability that I can read. He-solve this problem. So he can solve this problem. So in this similar manner, you're going to do all these sentences and you have to fill either can or could. Exercise 2, tick the correct answer. Here again, ma'am has given you two options in each sentence and you have to tick the correct and write it over here also. Number 1, God bless you. So the two options are can or may. So what we have learned that if we are giving a blessing, what will we use? May. So what will come here? May God bless you. In the similar manner, you are going to do it yourself and increase your knowledge. Okay, bye.